children of God. The problem with us is we're being taught that we don't have to have and shouldn't have to deal with disappointments. Oh, yes. What do you do after you pray for God to work a miracle and it doesn't work the way you wanted it to? What do you do after you fasted and sought God and you wrote the scriptures down that by your stripes we're healed? Your loved one still dies. What do you do when your heart is broken into pieces? What do you do when tears are running down your face? What do you do when your heart is heavy and seem like, amen, the church is insensitive to the fact that you're in grief, that you're in pain, and everybody is still shouting over the temporal and transitory things? What do you do as a child of God when your joy seems to be seeping out of your body? What do you do when you can't stop crying? What do you do when you find yourself trying to find a word and the words are not palatable enough to mend your broken heart? You rejoice in the hope of your salvation. Can I get a witness here? There's still something to give God glory and praise for. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Thank God, because of him, I can bear this cross. Because of him, I will survive. I didn't come to sugarcoat anything this morning. Because life is filled with ups and downs. Life is filled with swift transitions. Amen. Things can be going good today and be going bad on tomorrow. But last I checked, Jesus is the same. Yesterday, today, and forevermore. Somebody ought to shout glory. And so it is, my brothers and sisters. We have to go through trials. The trial of our faith is much more precious than that of gold, though it is tried with fire. The trial of our faith is God's divine plan. Thank God for perfecting us. The trial of our faith is mentioned in the book of Malachi. He said, behold, I send my messenger before me. He shall prepare the way before me. The Lord whom you seek shall suddenly come to his temple. Thank God prophesying concerning John and Jesus. Jesus being a refiner, he will refine the sons of Levi. Thank God the priestly people. That's who we are. We are a royal priesthood. We have to be refined by fire. The baptism of fire. John said, I indeed baptize you with water, but there's one coming after me who's mightier than I. Shoes I'm not worthy to unloose. He's going to baptize you with the Holy Ghost and with fire. That fire is your test and your trials. You're going to be tried. Just like gold and silver is tried. When it's dug and ored out of the earth, it doesn't come out in its perfective state, but it has to go through a perfecting process. And God has designed a perfecting process for us. If we never went through anything, we would not have heaven in our view. If we never had to cry sometime, we wouldn't have heaven in our view. If we weren't disappointed sometime, we wouldn't have heaven in our view. So our trials come just like the fire of a refiner. When the gold and silver comes out of the earth and fire is put to it, the imperfections of that precious metal separates itself from the metal. And as it separates itself from the metal, the refiner knows he has pure gold and silver. When he looks over and sees a perfect reflection of himself in the gold and in the silver, that's what God wants to see in us. He wants to see a perfect reflection of himself. himself. So you have to go through some stuff. You have to be tried. Your faith has to be tried. Think it not strange concerning the fiery trial, which is to try you, as though some strange thing has happened to you. Sometimes saints be wondering, why me? Why now? It's not something strange. God is preparing you for the rapture. The Bible says that we're being prepared for his glorious appearance. His glorious appearance is the rapture of the church. I know we've been talking about the rapture for a long time, but I'm here to tell you, when God's clock strikes, we will be changed in a moment and in the twinkling of an eye. It's just waiting on God's clock to strike. And it doesn't matter how many believe it and how many don't believe it. It doesn't matter who's looking for it and who's not looking for it. It doesn't matter who's prepared and who's unprepared. Ready or not, Jesus is soon to come. Will you be ready? And if you're going to be ready, you've got to love your way through. Because we haven't seen him. But thank God we love him. I haven't seen his nail-scarred hands. But I love him. I haven't seen his thorn-pierced brow. But I love him. I love him because he first loved me. I don't know how you feel about it, but while we were yet sinners, Christ died for the ungodly. We weren't fit to live, nor ready to die. But way back on Calvary, thank God he saw our knees. Look beyond every fault, look beyond every hang up, and said, I am your Redeemer. I'm an Alpha, I'm Omega, I'm the beginning, I'm the ending. Love him. I still love him when the odds are against him. You got to figure it out this time. Oh, he's the worst man in the world. I'm not giving him nothing for Father's Day. Can I get a witness here? But I come to tell you, when it comes to God, you got to be able to accept no sometime. They say, Lord, I still love you. I love you. Not for the temporary, but I love you because you gave me something that mama couldn't give me. You gave me something that daddy couldn't give me. You gave me something that my sweetheart couldn't give me. You gave me eternal life. Joy is stuff like this preacher been through. Let me see your hand. Do you love it?
Situation
and you press your way, it's because you love the Lord. The reason why you're here, and some of y'all, it was hard to get dressed this morning, but you got dressed anyhow, it's because you love Him. And He wants your joy
order for your joy to be full, you got to take it off your circumstances. Take it off your situation. And you got to see Jesus in this book.
Yes, sir.
And you got to see his promises in this book. And your faith has got to latch to it. And if your faith latched to the promises that's in this word, there's a power.
Yes, sir.
That's in you.
Thanks.
Now unto him that's able to keep you from falling. God can keep you. Hallelujah. Don't let disappointment cause you to throw in the towel. Don't let disappointment cause you to be in the church without joy. Don't let your letdowns mess with your faith. Somebody need to talk to me right now. Somebody need to talk to me right now. Somebody need to talk to me right now. Somebody please tell me, preacher, don't worry about me. My faith is intact. Ain't nobody talking to me. My faith is intact. Bishop Johnson, don't worry about me. My faith is intact. I believe God's word. And I'm being kept by his power. And his power is all sufficient. Came here. Somewhat of a burden. Because it can't be church as usual. Not with what we're facing. It can't be church as usual. Not what we're dealing with. We're dealing with some stuff.
Yes.
It can't be church as usual. The devil's time for us to be sensitive to one another. The time is now. There was a time for us to care about one another. The time is now. We need each other. We can't make it by ourselves. An encouraging word goes a long way. I want you, while you're standing, just turn to your neighbor, somebody around you, just encourage them. Tell them, keep on loving God.
Come to receive.